that show. That's how good that show is.
I showed Michael a little show for our Halloween-ness.
Let's go.
Guess it. It's an old show, black and white.
Old comes show, on, black and white.
Comes on in marathons on Halloween.
Old show on black and white?
One of my favorites of all time.
Mm-hmm. It's one
nice one. Yeah.
Oh, that's a Halloween show.
I guess
you could say it, because I guess you could say
it's
that,
spooky.
Yeah, it's like Black Mirror, bro. Mm-hmm. I like shows like that.
I love the show. How do you feel about it, Michael?
Well, I only knew of Twilight Zone because I'm a Disney kid and I know the ride at Disney World. The elevator ride.
Wow.
So I never seen the show, but I mess with it a lot, bro. It's really good. I'm not surprised it's really good, but it's really fucking good. Like, I love shows that try to be different and not the same thing. Like, every show doesn't have to be the same thing. I love when shows do this. Like, Atlanta does that too. They have episodes when it's like a completely different storyline. I love that, bro. And I'm probably going to watch the whole thing of Twilight one day, to be honest with you.
Let's go.
That's how much I really like the show. I like the style of it. I like the introduction with the main guy. What's his name?
Rod Serling.
Great. I loved him even from the ride.
Even the plot twists are pretty fucking good, bro.
No.
Those shits be guy. Crazy. Hitting you right in the mouth, bro. You'd never expect that shit.
So we first watched this episode with Wallaby.
Yeah.
I never saw the episode. My dad was telling me about it. There's a guy that fucking, he kind of hates his life in a way.
Mm-hmm.
And he's been going to sleep on the train and wakes up. And when this, like, I get, it's like heaven to him, called Wallaby. And then, you know, he's going through hell at home, whatever. He ends up killing himself and going to Wallaby. So basically his heaven, because that's where he's been wanting to be. That shit was crazy.
Yeah, like, Wallaby, what? That's not even a place, bro. What are you talking about?
And then after, I showed Michael the episodes.
Yeah. That second one, bro. It was the second one with the glasses, right?
Yes.
What, have you seen anything of it, Eric, or no?
I mean, I know Matt showed me some episodes about it.
The time one where the guy with the glasses?
Yeah. Oh, that's the episode?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yo.
Oh yeah, that he was like, yeah, bro. That's
yo. I remember the reference from Family Guy, but I didn't know where it was from at all. I was watching the scene, I was like, oh, that looks mad familiar. And then I was like, oh, Family Guy. I felt so bad for that guy, bro. He just wanted to read some books.
Is that when, like, I think he's in, like, in the, now, like, the world is destroyed or some shit.
Mm-hmm.
I remember that.
Fallout.
That shit was crazy. Yeah, Fallout. Exactly. That's exactly what it was.
Yep. Because the guy, he just wants to fucking read, man. He wants to read. His wife don't let him read.
Oh, his wife. Read.
And now he can read forever.
And then yeet.
I'm sure they'll probably see it on the video. He leans over, tried to grab his glasses that fell, crack. Over, can't see no more.
That's crazy, bro. That's insane.
That broke my heart. I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, bro, it was a twist.
Yeah.
You weren't gonna expect that.
And then I showed him. I think it's Nightmare at 20,000 Feet with William Shatner.
Yeah.
With the monster on the wing.
That shit was creepy as fuck.
You showed me that. I don't know if you showed me that.
I may have showed you it. Yeah, he's fucking a paranoid passenger who...
I've heard about this, though.
And he fucking opens a window and you see the monster fucking tearing the plane out and then scaring him and shit. That episode is wicked.
Okay.
I see that. I want to see that.
Man, there's so many episodes I got to show you, man.
What's another one we watch? Did you watch another one? Oh! The army one. When he's in the plane and then he ends up like 50 years later or whatever, 30 years.
Oh, yes.
I forgot what it's called.
Yeah, didn't they do a remake for the new version about that one?
They did on the Nightmare 20,000. The first episode Jordan Peele did was Nightmare 30,000 Feet.
Oh, I want to watch that.
This episode is fire because it wasn't like the monster one. He picks up a headset and it's saying everything that's happening on the flight. He's like, oh, it's this time, and you're sitting in this seat, and you're boom, boom, like it's saying everything. But you're thinking it's gonna be a monster on the plane, but it's not a monster at all.
Another plot
twist. Look at that, another plot twist. That shit was crazy. That first season was fire, and it has Ozzie Beats in it. That shit was dope, man. That first season was really fire. I didn't see the second season yet, sadly, but
damn, I gotta bridge these shows, bro.
Bro, there's some I love this fucking show.
Damn.
Black Mirror is great too.
Yes.
Bro, there's so many fucking shit I have to watch.
The good thing about those shows is you can just throw them on whenever.
Yeah, exactly. Because there's no story, you know? The story is already in the episode.
Yeah.
Speaking of another show, Eric, that you gotta see.
Oh, segue.
My boy Guillermo del Toro.
Oh, you guys saw it already?
Oh, man. We got four episodes to watch.
We got four tonight? Oh, my God.
Oh, shit.
I'm bro, Eric. Eric.
Damn,
Eric, it is mad shit, but hey, you know, hey,
how long are the episodes?
The first two is like 45 minutes, and I think the next two is like an hour.
Okay. So it's four episodes?
No,
so far, yes,
it's gonna be eight, right? I think that the third one's not 3 hours. What the fuck? The third episode is an hour, and then this fourth episode is an hour and 8 minutes.
I love it.
Thursday night is dedicated for watching shit.
Let's go.
Got mad shit tonight, bro.
Yeah, bro. There's so much. I think this is what? Episode 9 of Atlanta tonight? I think.
Yeah.
Atlanta.
But before we get to Atlanta, let's talk about the game.
Bro, I don't want to say too much.
About we're not going to go into detail now. But.
Episode 8.
What he's doing is like a bunch of I don't think it's anthology. I think they kind of all intertwine in a way.
Yeah, that one thing, right?
I don't say nothing
because I'm not gonna say. But he does have a bunch of different directors for each episode, which is cool. I forgot what show did that shit.
Oh, different directors?
Yeah, every wasn't Euphoria like that?
I don't know.
I mean, but a lot of shows do that.
I know Mandalorian does it for sure.
No, but like in a way of like, Mandalorian does it. But it's like it's his story, his screenplay. But I guess he just puts like certain directors to do those episodes, which is fire as fuck to do.
Okay.
So, does that baby?
It's crazy.
I'll definitely give it a watch.
Probably please. That shit is fire. It's only 8 episodes, right? Not the whole shit.
But the last two is Saturday?
It should be. Or tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, tomorrow. Yeah.
But I before I even saw who made the show, I was interested because it was a book I used to read, The Haunting Hour, back in fucking 4th grade or some shit. And well, it's like the same shit. It's like different stories of, you know, some creepy stuff that happens. And it's made by one of my favorite directors. So that shit is fire, bro.
Okay.